Welcome to Evolution of Self with me, Britannia. Hello, and I'm very excited to be sharing this week's topic with you because I've been experimenting and playing around with how I do this. And in the past, I tend to share things that I know about or I've learnt about or my experiences in the hope that it helps support you in your life. But what I'm doing this week is something slightly different, and I've decided I'm going to do it the same once a month because it takes a little bit of research, a little bit more in-depth research than I do for my other ones. And what I did was I posed a question to my contacts on social media and asked them about resilience versus endurance. And what I'm going to share with you now is a culmination of my own insights, my own experience, and the wisdom of the people that chose to comment and join in with us. And for that, I'm incredibly grateful. Whilst I'm not going to mention everybody in this video by name, I will either tag or post the names of everybody who contributed, because even though I might not necessarily use your example, all of your input contributed to creating this video, and for that I'm deeply, deeply grateful. Anyway, onwards and upwards and into resilience and endurance. Now, I learned something so quite profound, actually, because I had a conversation with Anna Marie Watson and Gary Hawke. Anna Marie Watson is an ultramarathon runner, as well as a coach for people who do things like that. And Gary Hawke is also a runner. And if my memory correctly serves me, and I'm sorry if I got it wrong, he does half marathons and marathons. So they both come from the physical resilience and endurance side. And what they led me to understand is that resilience is actually a platform for which endurance is then able to be built on. And through the conversation with Anna Marie, and I'm going to come back to that because it was profound on so many different levels, I got to understand that, I mean, I know this anyway, and you'll have heard it in many of the videos that I've shared with you in the past, everything is energy, and resilience is something that can be or is at different levels. Everybody has some form of resilience, and we have resilience in different areas, and I'll go into that in a moment. But general resilience resonates within a certain level within yourself, and it's either low or high. And depending on that level will impact your ability to endure. And when I first set the question, I thought of endurance as something that you choose to do, that you put your mind to, that you have to have the determination to push through. I was thinking of endurance in the work situation as well, and how, you know, in getting something done and pushing through to achieve a goal. But actually, what I've now understood is that resilience is the support structure for endurance. That endurance is something that we endeavor to, either we choose to do it, or something happens to us that we have to find endurance within ourselves. And our level of resilience helps us to excel at those times when we need to endure. So in regards to both Anna Marie and Gary, they were talking about endurance in the physical sense in the sporting world. And when they face endurance, generally speaking, in that particular environment, it's something they've chosen to do. To endure something like a marathon or an ultra marathon takes incredible mind power. But what they both shared with me is that you have to ensure that you have a high level of resilience to be able to hit those times when they're asking a lot of their physical body. Now, as I've said, both of them are in the sporting and the running world, but endurance happens in many areas. And in regards to what we've all gone through on this planet recently with coronavirus, there's been a request for endurance on many capacities. To endure means to survive some form of something that's a hardship. And it can be being shut away on your own. For a lot of people, that's endurance, enduring solitude. But endurance can also be stress, enduring a stressful time in your life, enduring pain or grief. So endurance is not just something that's a physical ask, and it's not something that you have to endure to hit a goal. Life throws these things at us. And I want to share something that one of the other people passed on, and I just thought the analogy was so beautiful that I really want to share it. It was shared by Jamie Larakis, and I hope I'm pronouncing your surname correctly. And the analogy is that resilience is being able to surf the tides of life, so the ups and downs that life brings you. And I love this analogy, but I'm going to change it very slightly, because having spoken to Anna-Marie and Gary, I think that resilience is the vessel, the ability, the seaworthiness of the vessel that surfs the tides of life. The tides of life is just what happens to us. We don't have control over it. It's just life. It unfolds. We don't know what's around the next corner. But how seaworthy our boat is, which is us, in this analogy, just in case you hadn't got it, how seaworthy our vessel is our ability to be resilient in those tides. And endurance is the ability of our vessel to endure what those tides bring to us, be it storms, be it sandbanks, be it whatever it is that life throws at us. There are times in our lives when we are all asked to dig deep and find endurance for something. But resilience is our ability to surf those tides. Now, I said that there's different areas of resilience, and I'd like to dive into this a little deeper now. So the areas that I think that we need to be resilient, or we need to be looking at to build resilience in ourselves, and I'll go into that as well, are our spiritual resilience. And when I talk about spiritual, I'm not meaning as in religious or a belief system. I'm meaning as in the truth of who you are. And when I talk about this kind of resilience, what I'm talking about is your purpose in life, your ability to believe in yourself, your ability to trust and have faith and have a positive outlook on life and have gratitude. All of this to me is wrapped up in spiritual resilience. And then obviously, as we've spoken about, there's physical resilience, and that's to do with your body's ability to handle the stresses that life throws at it. And yes, we were talking about running and endurance running, but it's not just that. When something stresses us, it doesn't just stress us from a mental capacity. Our body goes through a lot of challenges when we're stressed. And the more physically healthy we are, the more able we are to bounce back from that. There's financial resilience, our ability to weather what life throws at us, be it a broken down car, be it the stock market's crashing, be it some loss of some kind. There's a financial resilience that we can build into our lives. There's emotional resilience. And emotional resilience is such a key point, and I touch on emotion a lot through these videos because it's something that I think we still have so much to learn about. And emotional resilience comes into relationships. It comes into our relationship with life, our relationship to our partners, our relationship to friends. And there's social resilience, our ability to connect and communicate with others. And I spoke about stress, and this is where mental resilience comes in. It's our ability to manage the thoughts in our head. Because stress, all that stress is our thoughts causing us pain and stress, the regurgitating of past thoughts and pains that we beat ourselves up with causes stress. And our ability to build mental resilience will give us a much greater capacity to handle the stresses that life throws at us from a mental perspective. So I just want to run through those again. There are six different areas for resilience. There's financial resilience, there's mental resilience, spiritual resilience, physical resilience, emotional resilience, and social resilience. And for us to build resilience within ourselves to meet everything that life throws at us, we need to be making sure that we are resilient in all those areas. And how we do that is to ensure that we are as healthy and evolved as we possibly can be in those areas. So with the physical side of things, it's quite obvious. You need to make sure that you're eating healthily to ensure that your body is functioning at its highest capacity, that you have enough exercise to ensure that you maintain flexibility as well as strength. You also need to make sure that you build in things such as meditation and presence and mindfulness to ensure that you create space for your body to recover sufficiently from the stresses of life. Resilience is about surfing the flow. So it's allowing yourself to have space when things are calm and quiet, to allow yourself to recover from the times when the waves and the surf is higher and you have to maybe endure something. It's building in recovery and allowing yourself to flow and not necessarily be rigid that allows you to have resilience. When you start looking at resilience and start thinking about building the capacity of your resilience in your life in those areas, it's to take each one and ask yourself, what could you be doing to improve your capacity for resilience in that area? What could you be doing to grow that area of your life so that you are able to function at a much higher level? And remember, the higher you are able to function at, the more resilience you've built into your life, the more able you will be to endure something when it is thrown up at you in life. Something else that Anna Marie shared with me, which reminded me, and I'm most likely not going to touch on it too deeply in this particular video, but I'm just going to share it with you because I think it's important for you to know, and that she builds non-negotiables into her life. And what I really loved about it was, I know about non-negotiables, but I'd seen them already in my life from a relationship perspective. So when I was in a relationship with somebody, they shared that they have non-negotiables in regards to what they will accept in a relationship, which brought it into my awareness and made me realize that I can have non-negotiables in my relationships as well. Things that I know that I just will not compromise on, because by compromising on them means I compromise on who I want to be in life. And Anna Marie shared that she has non-negotiables, but she has them with herself. And these help her to maintain a resilient lifestyle. And one of them that she shared with me is she has a non-negotiable about when she goes to sleep at night. Because sleep for her is something that she knows that she needs in her life to be able to build resilience into her life. And strangely enough, and I'm sure it's the same for a lot of us, sleep is something that I know that if I compromise on my sleep, it impacts my whole entire life. I'm not able to show up as I want to in life. And it's made me realize that I need to build non-negotiables into my life about what I will accept for myself in my life, what I will allow for myself in my life, that will allow me to be more resilient in my life. And something else that I want to share with you very quickly is about integrity and building integrity into your life. And anyone who's ever done any coaching with me will realize how important and how highly I value integrity. And it's not because of the reason you might think that having integrity means people will see me in a certain light. It's actually about how I see myself. Because having integrity means that I believe in myself. And I will do another video on integrity if I haven't already done one, because it will take up a lot of time to explain it and how to build it and how to build self-belief. But it is vital to living a life of resilience, to have that self-belief and to have that high level of integrity, because it means that you will definitely have the tools and the equipment and the resilience in your life to be able to handle any challenges that life throws at you. And something I just want to end with was something that was completely unexpected that came out of my conversation with Anna Marie. And that was that most of the reason that I do what I do in this format, this sort of conscious awareness, my curiosity, my diving into it and exploring all of this, is because I know that when you're completely present, there is an energy that moves through you that is greater and more powerful than you. And when you're able to connect with that, it can carry you forward in life in the most magical and amazing way. Now, I stupidly thought this was the only way to connect with it. And through the conversation with Anna Marie, when I was asking her about the times when she had to endure during these ultra marathons that she does, and how did she do that with her mind? And she said that actually what happens is that she sinks, and these aren't her exact words, and I will be sharing some of the clips, so if you want to hear her exact words, then please make sure you don't miss them. But the essence of it was that she sinks into presence. That you can't endure something with your mind. You can't use your thoughts to push you through something. You almost have to let go of those thoughts and just purely be present with what's coming up. And in ultramarathons, a lot of it is physical pain. And just being present with that pain and allowing that pain and not fighting that pain gives her the capacity to push through it. Well, not necessarily push through it, but to keep going. And asking herself, what will it take for her to take the next step? What will it take for her to carry on? Is she still able to do that? But by being present, it gives her the space to do that. If she was in her mind, then it would be telling her that she couldn't, it's too hard, or it would be having a conversation, and that conversation takes up energy and space. And I just love the fact that we both were seeking this beautiful presence, but we've chosen to do it in two different ways. And I just thought that that was quite special and I wanted to share it with you. I hope that you've enjoyed this video and that it's given you as many insights as I gained from creating it. So much love to all of you, and please look out on my social media for the next question that I'm going to be sharing with my audiences, because I've loved hearing from all of you and would love to have even more input into the next challenge that I set forward. If you've enjoyed this video, please make sure you subscribe so that you don't miss out on any future videos that I share. Please also like, because it helps me to be able to share it with more people. And if you feel that anyone would benefit from this, I would really appreciate it and love it if you could share it with them. I also offer a free 5-day course to help people raise their own self-awareness. And if we're talking about resilience, the tools I share in that will most definitely help you to build resilience within your own lives. I'm also a consciousness coach, and I help people on their own personal journeys of evolving to become a much more conscious, self-aware person, either within their own personal lives or within their businesses. If you are interested in this, please just drop me an email. I'd be very happy to have a free chemistry call with you to see if working with me is something that would be of benefit to us both. And for any other resources, because I have many, you can find them on my website, which is www.britannia.com, BRITTANYA.com. So much love from me to you for the rest of your week. Bye-bye.